सो द टुडे टॉपिक इज बेसिकली मार्केट सेगमेंटेशन. वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस दिस द मार्केट सेगमेंटेशन. व्हाट इज मार्केट सेगमेंटेशन? व्हेन यू आर एक्चुअली मेकिंग सब सबसेट्स ऑफ द डिफरेंट कस्टमर्स, दैट मीन्स यू आर सेगमेंटिंग योर मार्केट. इट मीन्स देयर आर हेटरोजेनियस मार्केट इज देयर एंड यू एक्चुअली आर making it in homogeneous group. So market segmentation divides a market into subsets of prospective customers who believe in same way, those who have similar wants and similar characteristics that relate to purchase. So when you divide your market in some subsections, that is market segmentation. And what is intermarket segments? Intermarket segment is where do you well-defined similar clusters of customers you maintain but across national boundaries. Intermarket is basically when you cross your boundary, you have your customer even in India as well as some other country also. That means you are doing intermarket segmentation. Target market. What is target market? A target market is that when you once select your segments, then the second step is targeting market. The next thing, which segments in the market are appropriate to focus on in designing the means of reaching them. You basically segment your market in A, B, C, D. Now you have to choose which market is more appropriate, which market is more preferably suited to your company. That has to be main, that you have to put main focus on that particular market. So in between A, B, C, D market, you actually choose market B and D because you see there are more number of customers are there. You have more potential to work on that particular segment and you can make more profit. So selecting the segments in the market in which you want to put your focus to design the means of reaching them. Target market. A target market is group of people with some shared characteristic that a company has identified as potential customers for its products. So when we talk about the target market, it is basically you identify the consumer's wants and needs, then you actually select from that particular segment which you want to choose to be part of your company. So identifying the target market informs that decision-making process as a company designs, packages, and markets its product. A target market may be categorized by age range, location, income, lifestyle. Many other demographics may be considered, their stage of life, their hobbies, interests, careers, all may be considered. We have already discussed the base or segmentation. So that particular basis are very useful when you are going to choose the target market. Stages which actually appeared in developing market segmentation strategies. The first one is define overall product market in which company operate. You have to check the whole market where your company operates. You have to define your market area, market content so that you can make your product reachable over there. The second step is identify distinguish characteristic of segments or basis for segmentation. Firstly, you choose your market, then you actually identify your market on the basis of segmentation. You actually choose different criteria like demographic, psychographic, geographical, any base of segmentation you can choose it. In the second step, the third step belongs to describe segment. Then you describe segment on the basis of segmentation, on their characteristics, on their features, A, B, C, D, E. Next is evaluate approaches for potential and likely success. Then you actually study your segments. You actually go for the SWOT analysis on that particular segments, that where do you have to hit so that you can make more profit and you can retain your customers. Then after that, you have to select target markets. Then after making different segments, you have to choose target market by making further research on that segment, determine desired position, and then develop marketing mix to achieve desired position. But marketing mix is consist of 4 P's. That means you have to actually see the position of that particular desired level where you want to achieve by the help of marketing mix. Combining basis of marketing segmentation. We have discussed the basis for segmentation separately. Here we see we can combine 2 to 3 market segmentation to achieve the purpose. The first stage is basically initial segmentation, where you choose heavy versus light. The second stage is supplement segmentation descriptors. There you consider demographic, that is their income and education, and the lifestyle that came from the psychographic basis. So these are the 2 different base of market segmentation. Then you choose managerial decision. Then you have to select the media selection, whether it is magazines, outdoor advertisement, or it can be internet. You have to choose your media selection. Then you have to convey your advertising content by making a creative ad so that you can actually appeal your target market. Next is strategies of market segmentation. Demographic, psychographic, behavioral, and geographic segmentation are considered the 4 main types of market segmentation. But there are also many other strategies that one can use, including numerous variation on the 4 types. So other than demographic, psychographic, behavior, and geographic segmentation, we have several other factors that we can look into to go for more further segmentation. The first one is value segmentation. Some businesses will split up a market based on the transaction worth of their customers, how much they are likely to spend on their product. Keep it in mind, customer transaction worth. You can look at the previous purchase data, such as how many purchases they make, how often they make purchases, and value of items they purchase. So basically, you choose your customer here on the basis of the transaction they made. You actually saw how many times they have purchases, because that particular customer becomes a value customer. So when on the basis of this, you are choosing a segmentation, you are doing value segmentation. The next is firmographic segmentation. Business to business companies may use firmographic segmentation to divide up the business in the market. This is similar to demographic segmentation with individual customers, but instead looks at the characteristic of companies that may become customers. Example of data to look at pure industry revenue, number of employees, and location. When you actually choose the data on the basis of industry, the revenue concerned by the industry, number of employees you have, the location of your particular place of your industry, that means you are actually choosing firmographic segmentation. And in today's scenario, many companies choose it, as demographic is concerned with individual and firmographic is concerned with firm basic information like the size of firm. Where does it locate? How many employees are there? How much revenue they spend? So when you actually see the demographic that is related with firms, that means you are using firmographic. Generalization segmentation. Business may segment customer by generation and group them into categories that include general Gen Z, millennial, Generation X, baby boomers, and the silent generation. These generations are believed to share certain preferences, behaviors, personality, traits, and belief. Of course, not every member of generation is Of course, not every member of generation is same, but generation segmentation can give you additional insight into your audience. When you use generation for the segmentation, you actually go for generational segmentation. Life stage segmentation, you can also segment your market into groups based on where they are in their lives. Going to college, getting married and having children are the examples of key life events to consider. So when you are actually considering these stages of the life, then you are using life stage segmentation. People at different stages of life need different things. For example, soon to be a college student may need apartment furniture. New parents will be looking to purchase baby food. Seasonal segmentation. Similarly, how people buy different products in different periods of their lives, people also buy different items at different time of year. Major holidays such as Christmas also significantly impact the purchasing behavior. So when you segment your market on the basis of season, you actually segment using one of the techniques. Next is product differentiation. Product differentiation exists when a firm offering differ or are perceived to differ from those of competing firms on any attribute including prices. See, in this particular picture, the firm has one picture has particular CD that is of green color and other picture is consist of floppies. So when you differentiate your product from the competitor products, that means you are using the strategy of product differentiation. So you have to actually promote your product by making awareness to customer regarding the features and the quality of the products. You are actually using product differentiation technique. Segmentation strategies. The first segmentation strategy is undifferentiated strategy. The next is differentiated strategy. And the last is concentrated strategy. So the undifferentiated strategy is basically like mass marketing. It is a strategy that a company may choose to adopt if the market segmentation exercise has not been useful. You actually want to try to segment your market, but that has not been useful. So you have to again adopt the concept of the mass marketing and has not produced any meaningful substantial different segments. Then you use the concept of market segmentation. The strategy here is to focus on common characteristics rather than on differences. A classic example of undifferentiated marketing would be just about any Coca-Cola ad. Coca-Cola uses the same bottle design, same ads, same distribution channel to sell its iconic soda. And with just few exceptions, you have used undifferentiated approach for most of its history. So when you are not able to segment your market in any meaningful purpose, then you are actually using the concept of mass marketing. The next strategy is differentiated strategy. A differentiation strategy is an approach where business develops by providing customer with something unique and different. And it must have some items that is distinct from their competitors that they offer in the marketplace. The main objective of implementing a differentiation strategy is to increase competitive advantage. McDonald's is one of the fine example of service differentiation strategy. Apart from few rare exceptions, their way of serving is same in every outlet. Either you are in California, New York, or any other location, the taste, the presentation of their product will be the same. For instance, their fries will have the same amount of salt and size and will be served fresh everywhere. McDonald's itself has a differentiated product. No one has the same product, no one has the same market which the McDonald's have established in the market. Next is concentrated strategy. The concentrated marketing is a strategy that involves a brand directing all effort and resources to develop and market a product for one specific segment of the target audience. This strategy is exceptionally effective for small business as it helps obtain a good position in one marketing segment. So basically, consultation strategy is that strategy in which you put your all the efforts, you put your all the resources so that you can be able to develop a market or a market for particular product for only for specific segment. For example, ads created by Rolex watches convey that only successful, strong people with status wear Rolex watches. This shows that the watch manufacturer is targeting career-oriented people. So when you only target a specific segment, that means you are using the concentrated strategy. The next is counter segmentation strategy. An alternative strategy to traditional segmentation approaches is basically counter segmentation. It includes when you combine different market segments, when you actually accept lower prices over the variety, that means you are using counter segmentation strategy. Factors influencing segmentation strategy. The first factor is the size and the type of market is very basic, which actually influences the segmentation strategy. You have to check the size of the market. You have to see which type of marketing where you are working. Then you have to see the competitive factors, the strategies, the product, the offer, whatever the offering made by the competitive forces, you have to check them in very detailed manner. Then is product related factors. You have to see if the product lies at the life cycle. You have to see the stages in the product life cycle. Then you have to see degree to which the product may be varied or modified. The last, you have to see family size and financial position. You have to check the firm size and its financial position very well. Your firm size should be very appropriate, and your financial position, the company should be solvent and should not be near to any liquidation stage, so that the company must have good financial position. Estimating segment potential. You have to set time period of interest. You have to define your product level. You have to specify segment characteristic or basis. Then you identify geographic market boundaries. You have to see the main segment potential in the market. You have to check the interest. You have to see the product level. You have to see the basis to do market segmentation. And lastly, you have to check the geographic location of the market. The next is you have to make assumptions about the marketing environment. You have to make assumption about company's own marketing effort and programs. Then you have to make estimates of market potential, industrial sale, and company sale. You have to check how your market company is actually surviving in the environment, how your company is making efforts and program internal environment, and you have to see the market potential, their industry sales, the company sales. Developing forecast. The two methods that have been followed for to develop a forecast, the first is qualitative procedure, the second is quantitative method. If you are using qualitative procedure, it's basically related to where you can't include any sort of amount. You actually use the observed method. You go to the market, you survey your buyer's intention. You have expert opinion and you use the already sales force estimate. You use a composite of sales force estimate. And if you are using quantitative method, that means you are actually quantifying the data. You are using trend analysis. You are doing market test. You are using statistical demand analysis. That means you are following the data approach. You are actually quantifying your data by seeing the profit analysis or the trend analysis of your company. Firm and market potentials. For industrial level, you have the market potential, expected result in the market forecast. And for the firm level, the best possible result is sales potential, and the expected result will be sales forecast. And if we talk about industrial level, the best possible result, where did your industry stand? And the expected results of industrial level show you the market forecast, And if you talk about the firm level, the sales volume of the firm indicate your best possible results, and the sale forecast by the company for the near future will be the expected results for the given strategy. Targeting market segments. To select target segments, the firm must consider the segment's potential sales volume and profit, competition currently selling to the segments, and the firm's ability and objective. You have to see the segmented market sales volume and profit. You have to see the competitive strategies, and you have to see your firm abilities and objectives. The next is positioning. Designing a marketing program includes the product mix that is consistent with how the company wants its product or services to be perceived. You have to, last step is in the process of STP is basically you have to choose a market program where you have your product mix, where a company wants its product and services to be perceived. You have to position yourself in the market. The final step of STP is P, that is positioning. Positioning is concerned with the exact messages you put out, how you transmit those messages to give your target segments a reason to buy. Positioning is where the rubber hits the road. Specifically, you are looking at the wants and the needs of each segment and creating a value proposition that clearly explains how your product can meet those needs better than the product of your competitors. You put your exact messages, you transmit your position to your target segment here. Marketing positions refer to ability to influence customers' perception regarding a brand or product relative to competitors. The objective of marketing position is to establish the image or identify a brand or product so that customers perceive it in a certain way. For example, a handbag maker may position itself as a luxury status symbol. A TV maker may position a TV as the most innovative and cutting edge. A fast food restaurant may position itself as a provider of cheap meals. It means by differentiating your one or two feature, you are positioning your market, you are positioning yourself in the market. The last is mass marketing versus segmentation. Mass marketed is basically when a product has universal appeal and few features to differentiate them, it is available to everyone, like milk, toothpaste, computers. Most company markets to a niche, which means to particular segment of people. When you follow the concept of segmentation, that means you are actually putting the customer in different segments. And when you are following the mass marketing, that means you are not differentiating them. The main feature, mass marketing consists of all current and potential user of a product, whereas the mobile marketing consists of all current and potential user of product owing mobile devices who have been agreed to receive a notification. Communication channel is mass media, where communication channel is smartphone, tablets, and laptops. Content of messages, text, voice, video. Here, the content of message, text, voice, video. Receptant engagement is very low. Their receptant engagement is very high. Degree of adjustment is very low. Degree of adjustment is very high in this type of marketing. Positioning of measuring and monitoring the reaction is low, whereas their positioning of measuring and monitoring the reaction is very high. Time and place of contact with retail is client is limited. Otherwise, we have unlimited time with the client. Mass marketing is basically when you broadly undefined range of customers, and segment marketing when you actually one or two well-defined customer groups. The main goal of mass marketing is brand image. The main objective of segmented market is product positioning. The main target of mass marketing focuses on common needs. The main target of segmented market is benefits tailored to specific target audience. You actually specify your audience and you actually follow them, what your audience need in segmented marketing. Cannot track the conversation if you're using mass marketing, but you can your conversation, especially for digital. duration, long term consistency, but in segmentation market you have short term consistency. So the mass marketing, when you have same product offer to all consumer, when you know, do not follow any segmentation process. The segmentation marketing, when you actually follow different products to one or more segment. Niche marketing is basically when you have different products or subgroup within segments. In particular segments, you make subgroups, then you offer different products to that particular subgroups. Micro marketing is basically products that suited to the taste of individual or location. It involves the whole process of complete segmentation.